Let me bring in Shaina NC now, the Shiv Sena candidate from Mumbadevi. Shaina, how was your own election today? We'll talk about the exit polls in just a bit.
So Maria, as you know, mine is probably one of the toughest constituencies in all of Maharashtra. We have 1,40,000 Muslims and 1 lakh Hindus. And despite that, the kind of love, affection and public support I have garnered in this month is phenomenal. I'd like to thank our Honorable Chief Minister Eknath Shindeji for giving a Ladki Behen an opportunity to stand for this election, as has the Mahayuti leadership, and our Honorable Prime Minister for his uncomparable work in the field of public service and the Labharthis that have benefited through the welfare schemes of the Prime Minister. So I want to say 2 points here, that, you know, haar aur jeet to hote rehti hai, lekin jis andaaz se and the kind of public support that public has given across the board, whether it's the Ladki Behnas who have benefited from the 2.5 crore compensations given by the government and 7,500 rupees in their bank account, or the infrastructure projects which have completed in Maharashtra, whether it's the Mumbai-Ahmedabad bullet train, the refinery, the coastal road, the metro, the Atal Setu, the list is phenomenal. So people in the cities as well as rural parts vote on the premise of who is performing. And 2.5 years, the Mahayuti government has performed brilliantly and has made sure that every aspect of people's lives are touched. And so it becomes a politics of performance. And if you perform, you will never perish. But if you just play vote bank politics, false narratives, and try to appease sections of society, I think gone are those days, Maria, because people are way too intelligent to figure who to vote for, why to vote for, and how to vote for.
And interestingly, Bombay too, or should I say Mumbai, most Mumbaikers did come out to cast their vote, you know, so the voter percentage is better than 2019. You were concerned in the afternoon, how is the, you know, Mumbaikers unfortunately carrying that tag of apathy? They have certainly said time to shed that tag.
Well, I'm very glad, but we're just waiting for the final numbers from the Election Commission to know that what has been the final polling. But having said that, I think that Mumbaikers have become extremely conscious and very aware. And they know that, you know, they don't want any confusion. They don't want people who come together for lust for power and don't even have the basic dignity to acknowledge the legacy of Hindu Hriday Samrat, Adarniya Balasaheb Thackeray. They don't even take the name in so many ways. So the Congress and the Ubata Sena, obviously, they're only for lust for power. So the less said, the better. But having said that, I think that's for another day. Today, the day is for Mumbaikers. And as far as I'm concerned, I'd like to thank everyone in Mumbadevi for showering this kind of love and affection and accepting me as an honest face in public life, as a sevika who continues to work for the cause of the Mumbaikar across the board.
Okay, Shaina, before I let you go, because I'm sure you have to go back to doing some calculation as to how you have performed in every polling booth. So tell me, what's your assessment of the numbers which have come out? Exit polls are showing that it could be very well a mixed bag. You know, some are predicting a victory for Mahayuti. Some say that it could be a hung house.
So, Maria, you know better than me that exit polls are never exact polls. If you take Haryana as a case study, people had rubbished BJP and said not even 15, 20 votes. And look at the hat trick and the historic victory for the third time. If you look at the Lok Sabha elections, we had maybe overestimated and the numbers turned wrong. So I don't think I want to go into speculation, but I am absolutely confident it is the Mahayuti government and it will be a historic victory, again a hat trick, 3 terms in a row, and the kind of public support at every level. If you look at the youngsters, they've got internship schemes and stipends. If you look at the senior citizens, they've got pension plans. If you look at the farmers, whether it's the MSP or the Fasal Bima Yojana. If you look at the women, whether it's a Ladki Behna or it is an Ujjwala, the list is endless. And these are the vote banks we needed to focus on, and that's exactly what we've done. a developmental plan.
All right, Shaina NC there, Shiv Sena candidate for Mumba Devi, speaking to NDTV. I'll connect with you on 23rd when the results start trickling in. Thank you so much and wishing you all the best.